Hello everyone, how's it going, and welcome back to the magical land of Morrowind. Let's go in the barrow, because it is bloody loud out. Oh, it's so much better. Oh god, I couldn't hear a bloody thing. So anyway, last time we did a whole bunch of shit. I guess most importantly, we got the two ingredients that we need to cure our lycanthropy, which we're gonna do when we're done here. However, we are in Hrothman's barrow. The reason we are here is because we went back to Thirskmead Hall. Turns out everyone there, besides one extremely hot lady, had been murdered by a troll. We went at the Underfrack, if that's how you pronounce that. We went and murdered the troll. Seems to be true, because her story about peppering it full of arrows, it had a bunch of arrows in its back. It was also wielding like a Nord leg, which is a weapon we can use. We have a Nord leg that we can bash people's brains in with. In fact, let's do that right now. In fact, I don't think we can. Yeah, we're going to be horribly overencumbered. Well, next time we get a chance, we will. But anyway, we're in Hrothman's barrow because he was like the first chieftain of Thirsk. Essentially, if we can go in here and get his blessing by touching his great axe, I don't know if that's a euphemism for like his penis or something, maybe he's just in here and he's very horny, maybe he's alive, I don't know. I mean, I would hope so. Anyway, the point is, we go in here, we gotta touch his great axe, and then hopefully he can make us the new chieftain. And yes, my boots are still broken. Oh, apparently I'm not wearing armor. Well, bugger it. Too lazy to put it on, because you know I'll do it, and then immediately we'll turn into a werewolf, which is why we need to cure it. Oh, it's a bone wolf. Bone wolf is ready. Should probably point out, I don't feel great. Yeah, had a migraine a couple of days ago, still feeling kind of shitty from that. That's probably his great axe right there. I thought we were going to have to go like a really long way. All right then. Also, I think last episode when I was trying to loot one of these dudes, and I clicked on them and they had nothing on them, I think it was because I was actually clicking on like a regular skeleton or something. Okay, well, they do have some stuff, but yeah, you still can't take their armor. That's a little strange. I mean, I get why they do it, because the armor's like part of the character model, so it just wouldn't really work. That's his axe, alright. It's a skull we can't interact with. That's most peculiar. And an ancient chest which is not locked. I'll take the money. God knows we don't need it, but I'll take it. Hey, boo-boo! Who's been swiping my picnic baskets? Alright, take that shit. Okay, anything else in here? Is a very... He's like... Do you know what I mean? Like, he's dead. He's a skeleton. And yet, he's perfectly... Like, he hasn't fallen apart and, like, rolled all over the place and shit. Like, that's a neat body, you know what I'm saying? Like, those bones aren't attached by anything. That guy should be all over the bloody room. More like this fella. Alright, so, I mean, wait, is this the whole barrow? It can't be. It can't be. It is, isn't it? Huh. Huh. I thought this was gonna be huge. I had at least envisioned in my mind going deep into, like, a really, well, deep barrow. And then, like, at the very bottom, like, with some light shining down from, you know, a crevice up above. I don't know how that would work if we were that deep down, but don't think about it too much. Like, light beaming down onto the axe, and we're like, oh, and we see it in the distance. You know, kind of like one of the giant barrows in Skyrim, but I guess not. Fair enough. I mean, I'll take the easy path. I'm okay with that. What is this? What is that? Amulet of Infectious Charm. Why is that there, and why do I want it? You grasp the mighty axe of Hrothmund and utter your intention to rule over Thirsk in answer of approval. Hrothmund grants his blessing. I laid my hands on Hrothmund's great axe and uttered my intention to serve as Thirsk's chieftain. Hrothmund's spirit answered by granting his blessing. I should now return to the meat hall and talk to Svenja Snowsong so that I may be named chieftain. See, I still don't trust her. I feel like she's going to betray us when we go back, but I guess we'll see. I don't want that. Why do I want that? It's got a little wolf on it. I'll take it. I'm an asshole. God damn it. You know what, I'll see you there. Let me just find something to drop, you know, off screen so you don't have to watch. Nah, 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 nah. Nah, 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 hey, Jude. Oh god, that's a tree. Alrighty, we have arrived back at Thirsk, and apparently it's open, and there's people here, and it seems to be fixed up, and I still don't trust this person. But so far, so good, I guess. Have you claimed chieftainship? Most I've been away. Is that what you've been doing?
All hail the chieftain of Thirsk, slayer of the Udafrekt. May the mead flow forever.
Udafrekt. I've been saying Underfrek. I've been calling her Crandall. Oh, I've been making an idiot out of myself. All right, fuck it, save. So, I mean, I assume she's talking about me, but you never know. Maybe it was self thingy. Yeah. Okay, we'll go with that. My brain's not working terribly well right now. I know that Hrothmund has granted you his blessing, for I could feel it in the air.
I can feel it coming in the air tonight. Oh, Lord. Oh,
The heart of the Underfrecht? Underfrecht? I forgot what you said already. Has been placed on the pedestal for all to see. You, Jason McGrizzle, are the new chieftain of Thirsk. Apparently I was wrong to doubt you. I'm sorry. Do you want to be my bottom bitch? Ruling the Mead Hall is great work. They're great, and I understand you may have business. Dat business. Elsewhere, I offer to serve as your advisor and second-in-command. In other words, my bottom bitch. I'm okay with that. And will oversee the Mead Hall's affairs in your absence. Now, do we have any Mead Hall business? Dat business to discuss. Or maybe you'd like to relax in your quarters. Tell me about my quarters. Do you want to join me? Your quarters are upstairs, Mr. Grizzle. The chieftain's room is the one with the wolf skin rug in front of the door. There you can rest and have any privacy you need to masturbate. Because, let's be honest, you're sad and lonely. Oh, and if you haven't seen it already, I've left a gift by your bed. It is a true chieftain's weapon, one I hope will serve you well. Is it a safe place for me to store things? It sounds like we may have a quest line here. Bloody hell. There's me thinking like, oh, we've got like a couple of episodes before we finish the Morrowind Let's Play. It just keeps going. Just keeps bloody going. So wait, where's the... Wait. Oh. What, this one? It's gotta be this one, right? Oh, hello. Clanbringer! It's a... Actually, I was gonna say it's a bit shit. It's actually really god awful. Sanctuary, 1 to 5 points. That's bad. 4 to 5 personality. Eh. That could be good if that boost works for the, you know how we need more personality for, the East Empire Company questline? If that temporary boost from that works, that means we don't need to spend level up points on that. So that could be a good use for it. Rally humanoid, 10 to 20 points. Eh. I'm gonna leave it there for now. If we do need it, then sure. Can we level up? No. I guess I already got that personality point. I really hope so. So what I'm gonna do... Chest of drawers. Are these safe? What? They don't even work. Okay. Does this work? The cupboard does not open either. And there's a book. The House of Troubles. How long is the House of Troubles? Not that long. Can I be bothered? Hell no. My throat's killing me already. I'm gonna just drop some shit on the floor here. This is our room, apparently. Let's hope it works. And then I'll bring you back in and we'll see about the Mead Hall business. Also may go and fix my gear really quick. Alright, you know what? That looks largely good to me. All I really kept were the things that we're wearing and Hearsign's ring, so that when we want to turn back to a werewolf, we can. There's a lot of shit on the floor there, though. Like, a lot. Some of it very important. Even the moon and star ring is there somewhere. So... I realize that, like, from a storyline standpoint, literally dropping the moon star ring that proves that you are the Nerevarine, one of the most important things in the entire game, just chucking it on the floor in, like, some random-ass meat hall, probably not the smartest thing to do, but let's be honest, it ain't gonna disappear, because none of the other shit has, and we are nearing the end of the game, so... Fuck it, I guess. Anyway, like I said, I'm gonna go repair my shit, so I guess I'll put the... Actually, no. Before we do that, let's see if there is a questline here, because I don't want to repair my stuff, come all the way back here, and then... How do I leave? I don't repair my stuff, come all the way back here, and then find out, oh, actually, there's no questline at all, and there's just, like, one quest here or something. Can I take this back?
Slayer of the Udafrekt. May the Mead
Udafrekt.
Forever.
Udafrekt. 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 I'll try and remember that. Blah, 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 business. As chieftain of the Thirsk, there are certain things you may order the clan to do. As your second-in-command, I will make sure your orders are carried out. So, what is your command, my lord? Get on your knees and tell me you love me. So we can order mead from Skyrizzle, collect mead hall profits, send out hunters to kill snow bears and snow wolves, and return with their pelts. So it sounds like it's just, you know, like one of those collection thingies that you get in some games. Like, I can be like, go do this for me and collect me resources. And there's probably a chance that if I send people out, they might die. I might have to pay to hire more or something. I don't know. Do I have any profits? Great Chieftain of Thusk, I'm afraid you are unable to collect any profits from the sale of mead. We have run low on the sweet nectar and don't have enough to make a profit on. If you direct me to order more mead from Skyrim, I will be happy to do so. Skyrim got all the mead. Yay, all the mead. I mean, so what it's saying is, do I want money or do I want the pelts? Wasn't there supposed to be someone in the Mead Hall that we could use the pelts with to have something made, I think? For now, I guess just order mead from Skyrim. Yes, great chieftain, I'll put in the order for mead. It should arrive from Skyrim in about a bloody week. Good lord. Do I have any other business or is that all I can do for now? So I can send out hunters as well? is my chieftain, I will send out the hunters. They will kill as many snow bears and snow wolves as they are able and bring back their pelts. Brynjolf the smith can use these pelts to craft some custom armor. These are elusive creatures, however, and it may be sometime before the hunters return. Check back in a few days. Right. So Brynjolf might be able to fix our gear. That would be very handy. Send the hunters to kill snow bears and snow wolves and return with their pelts. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, so everything we already know. So who is Brynjolf? Is he like in, is he, what I'm wondering, is he here or is he back in the Skull Village? It's not you.
You're Benedict too, I'm Benedict, I'm a writer, don't you know?
Oh yes, I do know, because you tell me every fucking time. I don't see him here. What the hell, door? Ah! Ah! I'm stuck in the wall! Okay, that was a little strange. Alright then. Yeah, I'm sure Brynjolf is actually the smith in the Skull Village. But since we're a werewolf, he's probably not gonna talk to us. Let's try and kill that first, I guess. And then we'll worry about fixing our boots. So we should just be able to recall. And I don't think I marked it anywhere else. I hope not. So we should be right next to the witch's abode. The gloomy cave, as it were. Alright, this works for me. Let's make a save in case we screw something up.
My sisters and I must make our brew before the rite can proceed.
Yes! Make our brew! See, there are three of them. I swear we only had two ingredients that we were supposed to collect. Maybe I just didn't get the mission from the other one, or maybe there was only two. I don't know. Okay. You have brought me a bunch of ripened belladonna berries. Well done, Jason McGrizzle. The berries will be added to our cauldron and sweeten the brew with the flavor of death. Remember, you must also complete my sister Thalatio's task as well before talking to Etienne? Sure, we'll go with that. Okay, so what was the other one? Felice. And then speak to Etienne. So you're Felice. Okay. Now, Jason McGrizzle, you have returned, and with the petals of the Warspain flower, very impressive, the petals will be added to the cauldron and infuse our brew with the essence of the wolf. I see you have also completed my sister Isabella's task as well. Excellent. Now speak with Etienne to learn what you must do next. Exactly. That's not all we had to do. There's going to be like another long-ass thing. Your shadow is tiny. That's adorable. That's bloody adorable. Alright, what do you want? That's long-ish. So, you have completed your tasks for my sisters. Excellent. We will use those ingredients to concoct a certain potion, but it is not for drinking. No, no, it is for something else.
Is it a suppository?
But it is not... Oh, I already read that. Meet me at the Order of Thrond, and I will tell you what you must do next. Certain preparations have already been made. The cure is within your grasp, Jason McGrizzle. But the final most difficult steps lie ahead. Oh, boy. In that case, I guess I am going to try going back to... Well, no, we're right next to the Order of Thrond. Bugger it. We'll do it whilst we're here. We'll just accept the fact that we walk slow for now. So the Order of Thrond, I think it's just like right up there on top of that hill. So there's really no point in me cutting this out. However, I am thirsty and I'm going to drink the rest of my smoothie. So enjoy 10 seconds of silence. It ain't going to kill you. Never mind, that wasn't 10 seconds. That was good. Now this is fighting. Who said that?
Let's fighting love!
Also, no, 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 protect my balls! What are you doing? Oh, God. Wow, that body block. That was beautiful. Why are you so tanky? Stop summoning people, you... Alright. What is that? Oh, we have a human sacrifice, eh? Doesn't bother me. Whoa. Greetings, Jason McGrizzle. The rite of the wolf giver is almost complete. Behold the innocent on the altar of Thrond. Beautiful, isn't she? Is she dead? You're not allowed to like dead people. One of the locals, a very nice specimen, she still lives. Oh, okay, then she's hot. But barely. Your next step is simple. You must kill the innocent, remove her heart, and bring it to me. There is a dagger on the altar, but any weapon will do. Did I not tell you the rite of the wolf giver requires the sacrifice of both innocent and flesh? Okay, then. Alright, so where's this dagger? Gimme, gimme. Yes, I know. Innocent. I'll be honest with you. Look, okay. Put it this way. Whoa! Hey. How you doing? Okay. I mean, I could have killed him, you know. I guess she had to be innocent. But anyway, what I was going to say was, if this were real life, okay, this would be quite a stretch, but let's just pretend that in real life someone is, you know, wanting me to cut out the heart of an innocent so I can get something I want. probably wouldn't do it. But it's a video game, so we're gonna do it, okay? So just suck it up, Buttercup. Can I speak to her? Maybe I'll change my mind. Maybe she can convince me. Convince me with your words. She's in combat. In combat now? I don't think so. All right. Fucking death animation. All right, what do I do with the heart? I forgot what you said. That's it. Now, I will pour the Glenmorrow brew over the incense heart. The heart must get wet. Soaked, yes. There we go. Now, to recite the proper incantation. The Witch of Glenmorrow word utters a long, shrieking series of arcane words.
Come behind me,
we'll pretend something like that. The heart pulses in her hand as if infused with new life. There, it is done. The heart has been properly bewitched. That really hurt my throat. Has been properly bewitched. Now, place it back on the corpse of the innocent. Do this, and then speak with me again. You are almost free of your curse. Almost. I don't trust you. I don't trust you at all. Piece of bacon stuck right here between my teeth. What do I look like, a toothpick? What do you want me to do about it? I get the feeling she's supposed to still be on the altar. She fell off awkwardly, but let's pretend that didn't happen. I can't jump on the altar. It's like really hard. So I'm going to put the heart back on you. There you go. You are welcome. Does she turn to a werewolf that I must slay? I place the heart of the wolf in the body of the innocent. I must met. Okay. Etiana, whatever your name is. Yes, yes. There is just one last step, Jason McGrizzle. I must now recite the final incantation. The Witch of Glenmorrow utters another series of arcane, unintelligible words. Pretend I did the same thing. Behold, the innocent lives again. The woman has been given a part of your lycanthropy. Kill the werewolf. I knew it. And your curse will be ended forever. And not with that dagger ain't doing it. Ha ha. I'm sorry. Okay, nothing personal. Just, you know. Congratulations, Jason McGrizzle, you have survived the rite of the Wolf Giver and have been cured of your lycanthropy. Never again will you turn into a werewolf and never again will you contract the disease. Thank Christ. That was bloody annoying. I'm sorry, there you go, I've disposed of your corpse. Like I say, nothing personal. Feel like a bit of a bastard for that. If it were real life, probably wouldn't have done that. I mean, I can't guarantee, you know, I might have been desperate to not be a wolf in real life. Right, so anyway, let's go back to Thirsk now. Not Thirsk, the Skull Village. See if they're, you know, all good with us. And then we'll see if we can get our shit fixed and see what's going on with the whole wolf pelt situation and bloody blah. So I'll see you there. And hey, I can put my armor on now. Okay, let's try speaking to this guy, I guess. Maybe, yeah. The Bloodmoon prophecy is no more, and the Skull live on. The time of Tharsten Heartfang is past, but the Skull will remain, or remember him, rather, as a once great warrior who has fallen. Prophecy is ended, the werewolves dwindle in number. Heartfang, okay, I've heard whispers in the wind of the fate of Heartfang. He had been tempted by dark magic and was corrupted by it. I can only hope that our next leader does not suffer the same fate. As for who that leader will be, only time will tell. You would be a good leader, I think, Jason McGrizzle, but you are not Skullborn. While you will be remembered with honor, you cannot lead. For now, I will guide the Skull until a time when the Allmaker let it be known who will carry the mantle. So, I would imagine we would be leader had we helped them instead of becoming a werewolf. But it seems like, all things considered, even though we killed many, many, many Skull on behalf of the werewolves, you know, they're okay with it. They seem... Wait. Your name is not Brynjolf. Where is Brynjolf? Because isn't he the guy who can do the thing with the pelts and blah, blah, blah? I don't know. Snedbrr? What kind of freaking name is that? Slow down, son. God damn. Seems you have lifted the veil of shadow from your soul. No longer do you walk with the beast. The passing of the Blood Moon brings many great tidings. Sweet. Repair my shit. Thank you. This is very handy. Do you want to sell me some repair hammers? Because I'd love to be out doing that myself. You have one and it's apprentice. I'll take the prongs as well, I guess. Disappointing, sir. Disappointing. All right, but for now, boop. We can move quickly again. Oh, glory be. Glory be. All right, so. Hello, naked man. Alright, so what the hell are we doing now? I guess the East Empire Company questline, which means we need to go travel over there. And again, we can turn back into a wolf with this, apparently. Let's try it, actually. Let's save before we do that. Because, yeah. Boop. Would you like to use the ring? Yes. Oh, daggity. Oh! Bring on, you sons of bitches. Yeah. Okay, totally worked out. Perfectly. didn't get instantly killed and stunned to death. Nope, I mean, I didn't expect that at all. That's why I saved before it all happened. Alright, so... where the hell? We gotta go to a Raven Rock. Oh, that's a walk. I mean, I guess I could at least teleport near the Order of Thrond. Okay. Alright then. I mean, yeah, I'll see you there. Boop! Okay, so back over here in Raven Rock are we, and I'm now remembering what we were doing here when we suddenly became a werewolf and got stuck in the very end of the Blood Moon questline. We were killing, what the hell are they called? Spriggans. Around the colony so that they can, you know, safely extend the colony. Cut down trees so they can extend the colony. So, the problem is, we killed a metric fuck ton of them, and it still wasn't enough, and we were supposed to report to this guy when we were done. So let's hope we're just magically done. No, there are still more Spriggans. Shit. See, at this point, I'm wondering if it's just bugging out or what. Because, like, a brother killed a lot of Spriggans. Obviously, everything's gonna respawn now, so it's not exactly accurate, but there were many, many Spriggan bodies around here, like a ludicrous amount. So, my assumption is it might be over here. I don't think we ever went in this direction, it was more that way. So I guess we'll try killing the Spriggans, like, right in front of me. Like, in this immediate area, and we'll hope that's enough. I'm hoping we get a journal update that's like, I should report to him now that I've killed all the Spriggans. I've done some serious dunking, I have. Yeah, I'll probably cut this out, because, I mean, you saw me running around killing them before. It's not exactly different or entertaining, so, yeah. Oh, thank God. Okay. There was one Spriggan, like, right by this rock. Over here. Basically opposite, the bar where we have to go in. It says Jones be up there. I ain't even gonna read it. We know what it is. We killed the Spriggans. Thank fucking Christ. Good Lord. Alright, hello. Even though the Spriggans are gone, we still can't cut down this grove of trees. What? Some sort of magical heebie-jeebie, that'd be my guess. Either way, we can't start on the building orders until those trees are gone. Maybe if we could get at the roots or something, but we'd have to do that from underground. What? They've got to be way underground, too far down for us to dig. God, I need a shave. They're probably as tough as the trees themselves, so anyone that ran into them would know it. I'd ask the workers in the mine about it, but, well, you know, it's dark down there. Am I supposed to go into the mine? Is that what you're implying? It told me that the colonists have tried cutting down the trees, but to no avail. He guessed that something could be done if he had access to the roots, but believes them to be too far underground for him to dig down. Okay, so where is the mine around here? I remember it not having a map marker, I think. Like a door on the mine entrance? Oh, no, never mind, it's over there. Okay. So I guess we'll head into the mine and see what we can find. It's this, isn't it? Yes. It's gotta be the mine, surely. Like, where else would it be? That it is, not that it be! What? Why would I... what's the point of this? Okay. Why is there an entrance to just a tiny little, like, nothingness? Okay, well, we're in the actual mine now. I think we went this way when we were following a guy. I don't think we ever actually did go deep into this place. God, I love these boots, man. You don't know how much I miss them. What do you know? You must know something. Aldum. We all know your name's Adam, you lying bastard. I don't have to guard that room anymore. Falco said so. Cool. I can ask you about roots? Yes, I can. Roots. We had a real problem with those. Had a whole passage in the mine blocked off by them. And we just couldn't seem to hack through all of them. Decided it wasn't worth the effort, so we gave up on it. You can see for yourself, they're down at the bottom off of that northern passage. It is. Northern passage. Northern passage. I am lost. I don't know where I'm going. Is this the northern passage? It could be. Who the hell are you? Okay, where's north? North is this way. Ah! Nope. Shit. Abandoned mine shaft? It must be this, right? That's probably why it's abandoned. Jonathan updated. I checked the passage and found the roots. I should let... oh, come on. I gotta go back to the bot. Alright, I'm gonna put a marker here. So, because I'm probably gonna have to come back, right? Where are all these roots? I don't see them. Huh? Where are they? What? No, but seriously, like, where are the... I see water. Am I just blind? I don't see any roots. What? There's not even anything down here, is there? They're not even under the water. Where are these roots supposed to be? Dude, I don't... Whatever. Sure. Let's go back to him. Okay, sometime later of getting very lost and running around circles in there, we're back at this fucker. Not much we can do, blah, 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 roots. Really? That sounds like what I'm looking for. Can you take me to see him? Oh my god, man. What? I put a marker down there. Oh! Fuck it. Alright, I'll see you there. Ah! Okay, we've arrived at the abandoned passage, and I guess this is what he wants to see, even though I don't see them. This sure looks like the place, rather. These roots probably extend all the way up to those trees at the surface. I don't see them, man. Well, if this is the right place, maybe there's something I can do about it. If the roots are drinking from this pool of water, we can try poisoning the water to weaken them. If they're weakened, the trees might fall, but I'd need some bitter green petals. Can you get some for me? I'll need at least 5 of them. I doubt you'll find any on Solstheim, but you can probably dredge them up someplace more civilized. You want me to go back to regular fucking Morrowind? Are you shitting me? I think we're carrying some. I don't think we have 5. Oh my god. Hang on, let's have a look. It's under miscellaneous, right? Bit of green petals. I swear we were carrying something like that. I guess I'm wrong. Seriously? Like, they're not on Solstheim? These may enough if they're on Solstheim. Like, you really want me to go back to fucking regular Morrowind? Sure. Where are they? I don't see any. Ugh. I don't see any roots either. What's your point? Look, they're not here. Are they supposed to be? Hang on, I want to try something. As you know, I was going to turn collision off and fly up there, but the point of collision off is that you don't have collision, so I would just go straight through them. I wanted to see if I could, like, physically bump into them and see if we can headbutt them. I don't think they're here. Like, I don't think it's even that they're just invisible. I just don't think they're there. What the hell? I'm assuming that's, like, the Morrowind Overhaul graphical thing that's messing those up, because I would imagine they probably are supposed to be there. Shit, so bitter green petals. My only other assumption is that there's probably an alchemy place somewhere on Solstheim that might sell them, even if we can't pick them here. Well, goddamn. Alright, well, I may as well crawl back up to the top so I can, you know, not waste my time getting lost again. Was there an alchemy store around here? Let's have a look. I think there was. I hope so. Trader, you know, the trader might have them? It's worth a try, I guess. Alright, let's try the trader. Bugger it. Uh-huh. Can I ask you about bitter green petals? No, I can't. Can I ask you about the roots, maybe? And then maybe he'll be like, I happen to have some petals. Have them. Motion, Raven Rock Report, blah, 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 blah. Nope. Alrighty then. Alrighty then. I doubt the trader's gonna have them. I just really don't want to go back to regular Morrowind. It's not, like, that big of a deal, but, like, what a waste of time. Butter. Am I really carrying moon sugar? Oh my god. There you go, I'm not Uncle Touchy Hands, just relax. So, bit of green petals, buddy. You don't suppose you have any? You got a lot of random crap there. Got any alchemy ingredients to go with that shit? Oh, he does have some. Hackle leaf. Salt dress. A worn and weathered note. I'm buying that. I don't know what that's about. What if it's a quest that we have to buy the note, like, to learn of the quest or something? Not seeing him, man. I'm not seeing him. Alright, let's check out this note, I guess. I get the feeling this is either everything or nothing at all. I wonder where the notes... it's kind of long, but I'll read it. I am forever swimming around amidst this ocean world we call home. My limbs grow weak and weary as my eyes drift skyward in defeat. I remember how warm the earth felt as I lived and breathed next to her beating heart. I remember enough to keep searching through an ocean of tears, raised to astronomical depths. My dreams offer solace, where I return to distant faded memories. Though trees entwined with cool autumn air, my sorrow is lured by fragment bittersweet memories. I am at home as much as my world and consciousness allow. I remember falling into the most beautiful lake I've ever experienced. She swallowed me whole, like a droplet, and I was enraptured and enwombed within her bliss. The lonely windswept desert sky of my soul was filled by her luminous stars and warmed by her sunlit radiance. I gazed downwards in awe and saw it all reflected in the shimmering ripples dancing and playing about the surface. It appeared to me
as real as the very wonders it was reflecting. I stepped forward to prove to no one and everyone that they were by belief. For an aching instant, I was betwixt the two and the summation. Confusion befell me, and I fell through, only to realize I hadn't entered the lake, I had left it. With all of my remaining life, I howled at the heavens and collapsed, like a star on the shore of my youth, as my life's breath wandered away from the home it had harbored. I have been drowning on dry land ever since. This is some, like, poetry bullshit. I lay there, coital, for heaven knows how long. I felt eons ebb and flow in spans of seconds. It should be span, not spans. It doesn't make sense. I lived as intently as I could in those endless instants as the boredom of after droned on and on. The fires of my heart grew dim and became only the faintest embers of the roaring blaze they had once been. My limbs, heavy with the weight of the world, protested. I felt the longing of this life, which slowly began to ease the agony in my heart as I was gradually nursed back to health. Knowledge of record and history tried desperately to fill the yawning, nauseous chasms of my soul. I began to know the deadpan search for freedom and forgetfulness, and I released the hold on my life. Though it still lurched, pained in front of me, I just stared back with tired, vacant eyes as if watching the most fascinating of nothing. My mind drifted, only to be slammed back reluctantly, repeatedly and painfully by those I vaguely remember knowing, as if from a different life and age. I try in vain to forgive and forget myself as I paced on those plaster smiles and strain to look levelly. Levelly? I don't know. I remember, I forget again, I remember less. I am saddened at the thought that I have forgotten. I am not who I used to be. Though it pained me so, I was never so real as those lonely, lost times of my undoing. I'm torn asunder as at the thought of losing forever that which has changed my life eternally, and that which I fear in the depths of my soul will never be again. That which has gifted me with more pain than I have ever known in all of my lives, all of the lives that I know through my own. Who am I to ask this of you? Okay, so let's evaluate what we just read there. That was some poetry bullshit. Like, it seemed like this man almost drowned and was saved, but then lost his memory. So he doesn't, like, he vaguely remembers the people that he used to know and love, but because of the amnesia, he doesn't really, and he's sad about that, I guess. I don't know. That was very pretentious. I think that's what they were going for. That looks really weird. That actually looks, there is two wolves. Look! That's its eye right there, and that's the face. That's like two wolves! Oh, wait a minute, it's split in half. Oh, that's fucking gross. Ugh. That's me moon sugar. So why has he got that? That's really strange. Is this your note? Dunmer Village style. The Dunmer Village style. Oh, you know, I don't care about that. Alright, so fucking hell. Alright, I guess I'm gonna go get this stupid green petal, whatever it's called. What even is it called? Let's have a look. Bitter green petals. Someplace outside. Alright. Gonna go get them then. Catch you on the flip side.
May I help you?
Okay, so welcome back to regular Morrowind. We are at Kull, which is where we originally took the boat to go to Fort Frostmoth on Solstein. Now, I've been told, and by told I mean I looked up, that apparently green petals grow abundantly, usually in the West Gash region. Yes, haha, the word Gash is funny to me. So, I believe Kull actually is in the West Gash. So, like, I can't say it without, like, wanting to chuckle, if nothing else. So, I guess I'm gonna look around Kull Village and see. I'm finding, like, a bunch of weeds, but not the right fucking thing. I'm gonna check around Kull and see if they're, like, around here, because that would be really handy, let's be honest, because then I could just get straight back on the boat and carry on. I actually wouldn't even need to do that, I could just recall. I guess it doesn't matter then, how far I stray. But, yeah, I don't really know what we're looking. I mean, I know they're green petals, but I mean, I'm assuming they're green and petal-like, but hello. I don't know what they look like, exactly, other than probably that. But you never know with this game, right? I mean, they might not even be bloody green. But yeah, like I say, I'll look around, see what I can find. I found a bittergreen plot. I got a bittergreen hall.
Is that a bit of green petal? Hang on. Hang the fuck on. Where even are they? Oh, they're in the magic thing. Eh. So freaking annoying. Wait, what? Okay, sure. So where's the thing I just picked up? Okay, so a bit of green... What? Okay, so again... Alright, so that's what they look like. That thing. Right. Okay, so we got two. We need... freaking five. I mean, that's a start, I guess. Alright, sure, let's have a look in here. There's a yurt here. Have we ever been in here? There's no one in here. I feel like we came in here and murdered someone at some point. Is that just me? This chest is unlocked. But I can't open it. Oh dear, is that bugging out? It could be bugging out. Because of the whole, like, animated, non-animated chest thing. Maybe me changing it around mid, like, playthrough has messed with the chests. Test your chest, loveless. Can't stand the heat. Get out of the Wild Wild West. I don't know. It might have done. Hello. Don't find me. Get out of the way, fucker. All right. I think I might have enough. I have 10 now. Yes. Suck my huevos. I'm out of here. Boop. Back to Sostam we go. And we are basically right next to where we need to be. Kind of. We just need to go back to the mine. So, once again, I'll see you with the guy. Oh, so much editing to do this episode, so very much. On the plus side, I've ran here so many times that I actually remembered my way back instantly. Okay, roots, do you have them? Yes. Great, I'll take these and see what I can do. There's nothing more that you can do right now. Why don't you let the boss know things are taken care of? Okie dokie then, fuck you. Fuck everything about you. Hate you. Hate you so very much. Okay, I did it, Falco. Assignment. Grove of trees been taken care of. O'Neill has dealt with it, that's good to hear. Perhaps once those trees are gone, the Spriggans won't be so adamant about showing up. Good work, Jason McGriss will make a point to keep an eye out for them in the future. Yes, fuck you. Can I get a promotion, please? Very well, you are now Jason McGriss, Officer of the East Empire Company. That's my lacket. What's this, 4 more pieces. I'm glad you got all of them. Got them all to carry us, the smoother things go... Sure? I don't remember what that was about. I, like, vaguely remember that dialogue option. Assignment. Clearly we must do something to better protect the colony. As much as I would like to, I cannot rely solely on you to protect my site. Yeah. So, we'll need to hire guards. Sounds like a good idea. I think it's only fair that others take up the responsibility, but it's not something I would be willing to order any of them to do. I'd like to see if there are any volunteers first. Ask around to see if any of the colonists would be interested. Let me know if you find any. So you want me to speak to people and ask if they want to become guard? Do you want to become guard? Hi, guards. You want me to be a guard? No, I don't think so. Sorry. Do you want to be a guard? You could fight, right? Oh, you're silly. Hee hee. Why would I ever do something like that with all these big, strong men here? I'm sure they can take care of it. Wow. And there was me giving you some gender equality, and you just shit all over it. Way to fucking go. Get out of here. This is my house. Get up so I can put you down and so on and so forth. Eh. You only respawn once. What is this madness? Alright, fair enough. I get the feeling in the bar is probably where I'm most likely to find guard people. Like you. You've got nothing better to do, right, aren't you? You want to kill yourself and stuff? This will give you a reason to live. I'm an old man. I'd be of no use to you. I'm so old. Alright, fine. Fucking hell, man. Here's me trying to help you people out. My duty to help those less fortunate than myself. Well, speaking of helping those less fortunate, do you want to become a guard? Well, hello there, Jason McGriss. You don't look like one of the natives, and I don't recall seeing you on your last ship from Vonnefell. Perhaps you're a mercenary. I'm here to do some research myself. Please join me for a drink. So we already spoke to this guy. Didn't he want to, like, know the meaning of life or some shit? Yes, research on the Falmouth. Some call them snow elves. Yeah, we definitely went through all this. I guess I may have died afterwards. What would you have me do? I need you to investigate Solstheim's ancient sites, barrow, standing stones, that sort of thing. Who knows what information they hold? Here's 200 gold for traveling, expensive equipment. Oh, sure, yeah. If you find any solid evidence on the Falmouth's existence, bring it back to me here. I think we already did, because there was that one quest line where the Falmouth were mentioned. You've returned, have you found any evidence? I think so. I found this thing here, does it help? Let me see, no, wait, yes, oh, no. I'm afraid this isn't one I'm looking forward to, Jason McGriss. Please continue your explorations, and do be certain next time. Damn. Fucking damn. You want to be a guard? I probably can't even ask you this. I actually can't. Alright. Oh my god. Not yet. Piss off.
Do you want to be a guard, Rando?
How may I help you?
Greetings, Dunmer. I'm racist. Really, I've got to admit, this mining stuff isn't really for me. It's not that I mind hard work, but I'm just not enjoying it. There's nothing to lose, right? Sure, I'll give it a try. I mean, other than your life and your time and, you know, things like that. No, nothing to lose at all. I could ask the bartender, but she'll be like, I'm far too busy, you know, running the bar. And, to be honest, can't really argue with that. Makes sense. Oh, fucking hell. Alright. Let's bust this open. Mustard makes me feel good. It's a Ghostbusters reference. Someone the other day was like, they watched like Ghostbusters for the first time the other day, and then they were like, oh, that's what he means when he says that. How have you not heard the Ghostbusters theme? What special rock have you been under this entire time? Hello. Do you want to be a guard? No, can't even ask you. Didn't think so, because again, she's running the bar. You, I think I asked? Did I not? Did I ask you? Oh no, I have Cellar to look after, and I don't think I'm really suited for that sort of thing, do you? I mean, I don't know, I'm sure women can fight. My goddamn, you don't need to be sexist about it. We asked all those fuckers, what about you?
Bah, 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 bah. I talk creepy because I'm a dark elf.
Hiya, gods. Good luck with that. I'm afraid you won't see me volunteering. I have enough to do. Thank you very much. Oh, alright then. Slow down, Bell Biff DeVoe member. Ha! Ha! No. Well, alright then. I mean, I thought maybe with Bell Biff DeVoe being completely irrelevant now, you might think about doing something else with your life, but apparently I was fucking mistaken. Ah, here we go. I found another one hiding over here by the extension to the colony. So you're looking for volunteers. I've never been one to turn down an offer. It's gotten me this far. Maybe now I can go even farther. Sure, I'll accept. Alright then.
You're hired, buddy. You're hired. I'm fucking stuck.
So yeah, he was right there by that crap. The bar is over there for reference. If you are using this as a guide, like 15 years after the game came out. And it's also a let's play, not a walkthrough. But damn it, if you're using it as one, there you go. Doesn't seem to be anyone else hanging around outside, so I'm thinking the rest are going to be in the mine. That's, I think, like, a Freishag. Yeah, I've checked, like, all the houses, I believe. Alright, let's head in the mine. Yo, buddy, you want to be a guard? I can't even ask you. Is it because you work in the mine? If so, then we're wasting our time. Hmm. Well, so that rhymed, and kind of so did that. I can't stop rhyming, man. So, yeah, let's check this guy. If we can't ask him either, we can ask you. God damn it. This is interesting news. I was just telling someone the other day that someone needs to make sure this place is safe. It looks like I'll get a chance to put my money where my mouth is. Hey, I'll do it. Alright, so that's three. Alright, back off. I'm doing a freaking count impression. You're gonna ruin it. I'm thinking it's gonna be three or five. I went in there, by the way, and grabbed that icy Nordic frosty Deathman shit. I forget what it's called, you know the stuff. But yeah, I grabbed that. So, I feel like there were more people walking around the mine. Like, at least one or two. But yeah, now that we have three, that might be it. I think it's gonna be three or five, because, you know, Bethesda like to do things in groups like that. Yeah, you know what? After looking around the mine, I can't find anyone else, so let's see if that's enough. In luck, talking to colonists, hire guards, have you finished, or are you going to keep looking for colonists willing to accept? I think I'm done. Good. Who do we have available? These three kings of Orientar. Three of them have volunteered. Excellent. I'll see to it that they're outfitted with the appropriate equipment. Thank you for doing this, Jason McGrizzle. Don't suppose I can get another promotion already, can I? Because I'd appreciate it. I'd appreciate it. Where's the promotion thing? Where's the there you go. You've done admirable work for the colony, Jason McGrizzle, but you could use a lot of bloody hell. Work on your skills. Shit. Sounds like we gonna need like more where is it? Okay, hang on. Yeah, we need 33 personality now. I think we have 32. So maybe that sword in Thirsk really will work on this. I doubt it because it's a temporary boost. But if not, then we're gonna have to let, like, we're already 44, man. Like, bloody hell. Eh. Oh, I'm quickly gonna go back to Thirsk, grab the sword, we'll come back and try this. Either way, we're gonna end the episode after that, but I wanna see if it works first, so give me a moment to make my way all the way there. Alright, got me bloody sore. Let's go back again and we'll see if using the personality, speechcraft, whatever, booster. Wait a minute. Yeah, okay, it is personality. It does do that, right? Where's the sword? Fortify personality, yes. So this might be enough. Now remind me how the bloody hell I use this. Don't I have to find it like in the spell list? Clan bringing like down here somewhere, I think. Yeah, there you go. Alright, so we'll try this. We'll see if this works. Save. Boop. Holy crap. Did I do that on him? Did I fortify his personality? I don't know what I did. Where even is my personality? Isn't it on the left here? Why can't I see it? Oh my god, hang on. 37. Okay, so it has been boosted. Gotta get it. Okay, it's perfect. Alright, so it's 37. Sign. Wait. Promotion. That's what we tried to do. Please work. Don't admiral work. Shit. Assignment. It'll take a few days to get the guards trained up and to speed. Come back and see me then. So, we can carry on, but we still need another promotion. And that temporary boost doesn't seem to work. Shit, man. That's really annoying. Alright. Here's what we'll do. We'll wait like 3 days or whatever. Or until we get like a journal update, I guess. And then we'll see what he wants us to do next. And then we'll end the episode there. So 3 days. Is that good enough for you, buddy? Is that good enough for you? Probably not. Assignments. That's a few. A few is three, motherfucker. My goddamn. There is 4 days.
It is not one thing.
Alright, I'll give you five days. I got 5 kids to feed. There you go. Is that it? What? I don't know what he wants then. I don't know what is this thing? Oh, this is the sword. Yeah, I don't know what he wants. It's kind of cool looking sword. I like it. Okay, well, yeah, I guess I'll keep waiting around and then next episode we'll carry on with whatever he wants us to do whenever, you know, the time is actually finally up. And if we do have to get the promotion, I'll try and do some training off screen. What I can probably do is find like an NPC or something just to train my skills so I don't have to go, you know, smacking things. Because, I mean, you look at our stats, the things that we use in particular. Blunt, it's maxed out. Medium armor, very high. Athletics, pretty damn high. I mean, almost as high. These two, not exactly low. I mean, yeah, like what I'm supposed to do is just run around jumping all over the fucking place? So, I'm probably going to try and find an NPC just to train my skills up just so we can put that point straight into personality to carry on because I just want to do this questline, you know? At this point, it's not about building our character. We're almost done. But yeah, other than that, thank you for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, I always appreciate a like, and I will see you next time for more Morrowind!